Welcome back everyone. Today section 6 we will start. So last class we discussed about matrix manipulation and some basic idea about the characters. So today we are going to discuss the same idea which we discussed earlier, that plotting graph, but we are going to introduce a new concept called g-text. It's very very nice to do also this kind of problems. So here one question is given. There are three curves are given, y1 equal to sine x, y2 is equal to x, and y3 equal to x minus x cube by 6 plus x raised to 5 by 120, right? Three curves are there, and we need to plot these three curves in one single graph. And since the variables are same, x only the variables, so that we can take one x value, or maybe starting from 0 to 2 pi, and we can plot these three curves in the single graph, right? So if you look at this program, so this we can do it in a command window, and whenever you required in a program, you can use the same thing in the script file also. So 0 to 2 pi, as usual, we have to consider n number of terms, since maybe if you look at the second equation, that is y2 is equal to x, is a straight number, straight line. So we don't need to take n number of elements in this one, since it's a straight line, you need only initial and final values. But since there are other two equations which required n number of values, since it's a curvature. So curvature means you cannot have a proper curvature until unless there is n number of x and y values. Okay, so that is the reason 0 to 2 pi, we divided into 1000 equal parts using the Lin space, and we have found y1 is nothing but sine of x, and y2 is equal to x, and y3 is nothing but the equation which is given, that is x minus x cube by 6. So here dot star dot power is there, that is because it is x cube. X is a vector, so x into x into x, that has to be, it is not a vector, it's not a matrix cube, it is just a array of elements cube, so that individually you have to find the cube of each element. So here also x dot raised to 5 divided by 120. Up to here is find the plot x1, xy1, xy2, xy3, or you can use the hold command also, we can use that there. Okay, anyway, I'm just going to write this program and we'll come to g-text. What do you mean by g-text? I'll just see this one. Okay, I'll just write a program. I'll just do it in the command window. I don't want everything. I'll just go with the app to the axis. Then we will discuss a little bit about the hold on and hold off once again. Okay, so this is how you will be getting the, and you can give x label, y label, legend, whatever you can give it. So here, so one thing is here you see the plot xy1, xy2, xy3 is there. The similarly, you can use the hold off option also. What is hold on and hold off? First we will plot one, that is plot x comma y1, right? Just plot it. So what I need to do, I need to say that hold on, I'll hold on, then plot x comma y1 is already done, right? So x comma y, I'll take y is not there, y2, okay, y2, yeah, y2 is there, so let's take y2 and plot x comma y3. Okay, so if you look at the figure, you'll be having the three figures, s comma y1, s comma y2, and s comma y3. These three figures are given here. Okay, so now using the, this is hold on, or you can directly write a plot xyz graph, plot xy, same, this graph will be coming, plot x1 y1, together we can do it. Now if you put the legend, okay, I'll just put the x label. X label is what? I'll just put x only, x axis. You have to put in a single inverter, x axis. Right. And y label is nothing but we can put some value that is function. I'll just put function. And title I can give maybe symbol. I just say floating the functions. Floating the functions. So just look at the figure and you can get the title, x-axis, y-axis, everything is given. Now, legend, if you put legend, what is a legend? Legend is nothing but to differentiate the curves or specific values in the figure. Figure window, right? It's a legend. I'll put first one is what? Y1. Y1 is basically sine. And y2, I can just say x itself. And y3 is the equations. The equation, I don't want to write everything. This equation I can write. Now you see that figure will be having sine x. But here it is just, it is kept here. But if I want to make it, I mean, legend, there are so many options in legend, you can just, one more thing I want to mention here, that if you have any doubts in the syntax or, any modification should be done, you have always have something called help, you can just put legend. So if you press help legend, whatever the related to legend in MATLAB will be shown here. Everything will be shown. So example, another one I can say that help sum. See, sum we have used, so we can have a different type of sum wherever it's used in MATLAB, everything will be. So CL help will be always useful to identify certain things. Maybe you are doing a problem and suddenly you forgot the syntax. You can actually make use of that. Okay, now here anyway, since we are having this plot, I'm just writing once again. Lunch space and y1 value. y2 value. So up and down arrow only I'm using right now. And enter. I3 is there, then plot. Okay, then I'll put x label, y label also. X label, y label, legend also I'll put. Now I want is this, if you look at the figure, I want to mention something here or maybe something here. I mean, I'm just telling that some point here, some point here, some point here. Is here I want to mention something, or maybe here I want to mention something, here I want to mention something. So how will you do that in this figure? So for that we can introduce a new thing called G text. Let's see what is going to happen in G text. Just write the G text of single inverter. First one is sine x, right? I mean, okay, sine x, or you can say that sine wave, sine approximation or something, approximation. So once I click enter, sorry, something is not coming. Okay, sorry, it's not GE, G text only, G text. It's a mistake here, GE is there, G text will be there. If I press enter, see here, nothing is there in the figure. There is no change in the figure. But if you bring the cursor to the figure, you can see something like this. See here, I'm not doing anything else. I'm just keeping that cursor. I'm just keeping that cursor. Look, cursor will be looking here. It will be like that. Now, if I press, let's take a first one is we have put a sine approximation. So let's take this is a sine approximation. I just keep it here or here or wherever you want. I just put it here. Just click your left mouse click. If you put the left mouse click, that whatever is you written here in the G text, it will be appear here. Okay, next one, I'll just put another G text. I can write linear approximation. Linear approximation, enter. So sorry sorry again and again I'm writing it's g text is g text okay once I press enter again with this one okay so this let's take this is a linear approximation so just click there it will come there now I'm one more is there I'll just write that also text g text what else is Taylor series Taylor's series output so once it coming here the figure will be come automatically so I can just click here and say Taylor series so this is the helpful tool to you know mark certain things in the curve you can use the g text so once you run the program it's the same thing you can write it in the script file also once you run it the figure will be popped up and wherever you want to keep that point you can keep it anywhere okay so that is the function of g text okay so anyway everything is given here so you can have a look at this figure and so see the next one that is what I want to talk about the g text see the next one plot the graph of following equation fill it with a black color so here the thing is the equation if you look at the equation sigma equal to root 2 sin phi t it's not x and y right it is actually after seeing the question itself we can understand this is nothing but a polar coordinate system because you have only one value t is there sigma is there and t is varying from 0 to 2 pi so 0 to 2 pi is t is varying then you are having a sigma value it's like a polar coordinate equation r and theta value so here how will you do that so it's a very simple thing because t is there so first thing is t has to be divided into n number of terms so here I can just use this one or lin space also you can use no problem lin space of what 0 to 2 into pi maybe 100 just take 100 or something whatever you want and write the equation of sigma that is nothing but square root of there is a function we call here square root of 2 sin phi t so 2 sin phi t we have considered absolute here absolute because we don't want to get a negative value here inside because we cannot solve that we cannot plot that so that we use the absolute value that is nothing but the modulus of whatever the value you are getting here 2 sin phi t so that is why we use the absolute or modulus you will get only positive value you will be getting now instead of using plot this plot is for x and y that is used in cartesian coordinate system so here we are not going to use plot instead of that we use something called polar because since it is in r and theta form that is nothing but t comma r this indicates theta that indicates radius or corresponding theta okay so polar t comma r the same function we can do like whatever you did in the plot maybe you can draw with some lines red color or whatever the same configuration or same kind of things we can do it with the polar also okay polar theta is r radius so that will give you that will actually create this particular figure so here if you look at this one x and y is there so since there is one more thing fill it with a black color even you need to fill the gap with the black color whatever the this is created here that has to be filled with a black color so for that what we need to do is we will find x and y value once you have the x and y value what you will get x and y value you use another function called fill if you want to fill any kind of graph or any kind of contour with some color so you can use the directly you can use fill of x comma y with the black color k right so like that we can fill it so here we just basic idea is you have to familiar with absolute is nothing but the modulus of value and familiar with the polar you can use the polar also to plot a graph let's take See here, nitrate comes. See here, if you are just plotting polar alone, if you are not filling it with that, so you can see that 0 to 2 pi variation of theta and corresponding radius as there. So this blue color indicates the like that you can change or try to do that also. See here, become red. So whatever the things you want, you can just play with that. If you want to fill this one, we cannot have a you have to convert into Cartesian coordinates, then only you can use that fill option. So that I just want to find what is x value. So x, we know that x is nothing but r cos theta and y is nothing but r sine theta. So using the fill x comma y comma k, we can just take. So that means your complete will be in Cartesian coordinate now. It's not in polar coordinates. It is in Cartesian coordinate, and you will be this figure will be filled with the blank. Maybe like you can have a different color of blue. That is also possible. See, the blue will be there. Okay. So that is here. Mainly we can say that we have learned few things. Absolute, polar is there, fill is there. Okay. Okay, the rest we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.